Hello students, welcome to another session on the unit of kinematics. What we have studied previously, the concept of point mass object, motion in 1, 2 and 3D, distance and displacement, and the concept of average speed and average velocity. If you want to learn any of these things, do check the previous videos. Now, what are we doing in this video? We will study about relative velocity and we will do a few questions based on relative velocity. Let's start with having a quick recap of what we have studied. So the topic study is speed, the formula velocity, then uniform motion, non-uniform motion, average speed and average velocity. Now let us start our concept, that is relative velocity in one dimension. So what is this relative velocity? So the relative velocity of an object with respect to another object is the velocity with which one object moves with respect to another object. Now in this there are two cases, one in which both the objects are moving in the same direction and the other scenario in which they both are moving in opposite direction. So let's take the first case when both the objects are moving in the same direction. So I have two objects A and B moving with velocities VA and VB in the same direction. Now what we are doing, we add negative of the velocity of B to both A and B. That is minus VB is added to both A and B. Due to this, you can see and understand that the body B comes to rest because this is plus VB, this is minus VB, the sum of the two will give me zero. So body B comes to rest while body A keeps on moving with a velocity VA minus of VB. Here VAB is the velocity of A with respect to B. Now let us take the next scenario in which both the objects are moving in opposite directions. So we have the objects VA moving with a velocity VA and object B moving with a velocity VB, but the direction of motion of B is opposite to the direction of motion of A. Now what we do, let A keep on moving with its velocity VA in the same direction, but we change the direction of motion of B. That is only direction, not the magnitude. So this becomes minus of VB. Now what we are doing, we are adding the negative of this velocity, that is the negative of minus VB, that is plus of VB, to both A and B. Due to this, the body B comes to rest because you can see here it is minus of VB, here it is plus of VB, so the total is zero. While body A keeps on moving with a velocity VA plus VB, that is A is moving with a higher velocity with respect to B in this case. And again, VAB is the velocity of A with respect to B. Now the conclusion is that if the two objects are moving in the same direction and you need to find the relative velocity, in that scenario you need to subtract. That is VAB is equal to VA minus VB, and if they are moving in opposite direction we add them. That is VAB is equal to VA plus of VB. Let us do a few questions to understand the concept. The first example, okay, there are two trains which are moving in opposite directions with velocity 42 km per hour and 30 km per hour. In what time will they completely cross? The lengths are also given, and the hint is in crossing, total length is the sum of the individual lengths of the trains. So this is train A, this is train B. Train A is moving with a velocity of 42 km per hour. Its length is 120 meters. Train B is moving with 30 km per hour and its length is 80 meters. So this is what is given. We converted 42 km per hour into meter per second. that gives me 11.7 meter per second. Similarly, we did for VB, that gave me 8.3 meter per second. Now, this was according to the question, the trains crossed. So, the relative velocity of A with respect to B is VAB is equal to VA plus VB, because in opposite direction, the velocities are added. So, we put the values and we get VAB is equal to 20 meter per second. And as it was given in the hint itself, that when they are crossing, the total length is equal to the sum of the lengths. So, that gives 120 plus 80, that is 200 meters. Now, we all know velocity is equals to distance upon time or displacement upon time. Okay, so VAB is equal to L by T, or T is equals to L by VAB. So, 200 by 20, that is 10 seconds. Let's move to second example. So, there are two buses, okay, that started simultaneously towards each other from towns A and B. Okay, these are towns A and B. The distance is 480 kilometer. Okay, let VA be the velocity of bus starting from town A, and VB be the velocity of the bus starting from town B. Okay, so this is moving with a velocity 60 km per hour, that is this bus which was moving from town A to B. The distance is 480, it takes 8 hours, that's for 60 km per hour. For the other bus, that is VB, it is 480 by 10, that is 48 km per hour, because it was given that the second bus takes 10 hours. Okay. Now, the bus are moving and we have to find when and where they meet. So, the relative velocity will be VAB equal to VA plus VB, because in opposite direction we add them. That is 60 plus 48, 108 km per hour. Again, velocity is equals to S by T, or T is equals to S by VAB. 480 by 108, that is 40 by 9 hours. That's the time at which they will meet. Now, distance from A. So, distance is equals to velocity into time. That is the velocity 60 into the time 40 by 9. That gives me 266.7 kilometers. Okay, let's move to question number 3. A police jeep is chasing a culprit going on a motorbike. The motorbike crosses a turning at a speed of 72 km per hour. The jeep follows with a speed of 108 km per hour, and it crosses the turning 10 seconds later after the bike has crossed. Okay, we have to tell at what distance the jeep catches the bike. Okay, so let X be the turning and Y be the point at which the police is catching the thief. So this is the thief moving with a velocity 72 km per hour, that is 20 meter per second. Okay, this is the police car moving with a velocity 108 km per hour, that is 30 meter per second. Let us suppose that the police catches the thief after T seconds. So now the police has, you know, caught the thief. So, according to the question, the distance covered should be same. Okay, this distance should be same. Now, police was moving with 30 and T is the time after it caught. And the thief had 10 seconds more. That's where 20 into T plus 10. Let us solve this. And on solving, we get T is equals to 20 seconds. Now, distance is 30 into T. That is 600 meters. Let's move to question number 4. Two trains, each of length 100 meter, are running on parallel tracks. One crosses the other in 10 seconds, while the other overtakes the other in 20 seconds. Calculate the velocity. So, these are the two trains. Now, the first scenario is they are crossing. So, crossing means opposite direction. So, VA plus VB is equal to 200 by 10, that is 20. As we know, opposite direction we need to add. The second scenario, the train is overtaking. So, same direction we need to subtract. That's why VA minus VB is equals to 200 by 20. That is 10. Okay. Now, what we will do from 1 and 2, that is when we add equation 1 and equation 2, we get 2A is equals to 30. That is VA is equals to 15 meter per second. And from equation 1, if we put the value of VA, we get the value of VB. Okay, let's move to question number 5. A police jeep on a patrol duty is moving with a speed of 54 km per hour. Thief is running with 126 km per hour, same direction. The police sub-inspector fires at the bike of the thief. The muzzle speed is 100 meter per second. Now the question is, with what speed will the bullet hit the bike of the thief? So let's have an animation for this. So this is the whole question. The velocity of jeep is 54 km per hour, that is 15 meter per second. The velocity of the bike is 126 km per hour, that is 35 meter per second. The velocity of bullet is 100 meter per second. Now let us first find the relative velocity of the thief with respect to the police. That is Vt minus of Vj, because they are moving in the same direction. That is 35 minus of 15, that gives me 20 meter per second. And what we have to find? The relative velocity of the bullet with respect to the thief. Now here the velocity of the bullet we know, but for the thief I will take with what relative velocity is the thief moving with respect to the police, because the police was also moving, so that relative velocity I'm taking. I mean, the relative velocity of the bullet with respect to thief is equal to velocity of bullet minus the velocity of the thief with respect to the jeep. That is 100 minus of 20, that gives 80 meter per second. Let us move to question number 6, the last example that we are doing to understand relative velocity. So this is a long horizontal belt. This is the child who is moving to and fro with a velocity of 9 km per hour with respect to the belt. That means 9 km per hour is the relative velocity. Okay. The parents are located 50 meter apart. The belt is moving with 4 km per hour. This is the stationary observer. And we have to find the speed of the child in the same direction, in opposite direction, the time taken by the child, and which of the answers alter if motion is viewed by one of the parents. So what is given? The velocity of the belt is 4 km per hour. The velocity of child with respect to belt, that is VCB, that is relative velocity, 9 km per hour. So let VC be the velocity of child. The first case, the child is moving in the same direction. So VCB is equal to VC minus of VB, because in same direction we subtract. We have the values, we put the values, and we get VC is equals to 13 km per hour. Let's take the second case. In this we add, because we have to find the speed of child in opposite direction, and in opposite direction we add the velocities. We have the values and we get VC is equals to 5 km per hour. Let's move to the third case. In the third case we need to find out the time. Now we all know that velocity is equals to displacement or distance upon time. Here the direction we are not considering, that's why distance also you can say. Okay, here VCB is used because the child is moving on the belt. If the child was stationary, if the belt wasn't moving, then in that scenario we would have taken the velocity of the child only. So T is equals to S by VCB, that is 50 divided by 9 into 5 by 18, because this was in kilometer per hour, we converted into meter per second and we got 20 seconds. Also, A and B are altered if motion is viewed by one of the parents, while the C part, that is the time taken, remains same. Now it is the time for a quick recapitulation. We know that when the objects are moving in same direction, then we subtract the velocities. When they are moving in opposite directions, we add the velocities. Let us do a few questions. This is the assignment. Only 6 questions. I will suggest you to pause the video, try the questions on your own, and then continue watching the video for the answers. Now let us start the answers. Question number one, what is the relative velocity of two bodies having equal velocities and moving in the same direction? Answer is zero, because when they are moving in same direction, we subtract the velocities, and here the velocities are same, so answer is zero. Why does the speed of other car moving in opposite direction of the car of the observer appears to move faster? Now see, both are moving in opposite direction, and this is to an observer standing on the ground. When they are moving in opposite direction, what we do? We add the velocities. So that's why the total velocity increases for the observer on the ground. Question number three. Two particles A and B are moving along the same straight line. B is ahead of A. Velocity is remaining same. What would be the effect on the magnitude of relative velocity if A is ahead of B? The answer is no effect, as the relative velocity remains constant. Question number four. A policeman moving on a highway, okay, the speed of van is 30 km per hour. Thief is moving with 192 km per hour. The muzzle speed is 150 meter per second. Okay, with what speed does the bullet hit the thief's car? This is just like the example that we have done earlier. So let's have a visualization. Okay. Now the velocity of Jeep is 30 km per hour, that is 8.3 meter per second. The velocity of thief's bike is 192 km per hour, that is 53.3 meter per second. And the velocity of bullet is 150 meter per second. Now the relative velocity of the thief with respect to police, they both are moving in the same direction. So we will subtract the velocities. That is 53.3 minus 8.3, and that gives me 45 meter per second. That means the thief is moving with a velocity of 45 meter per second with respect to the police car. Now I need to find out the relative velocity of the bullet with respect to the thief. As the thief with respect to car is moving in the same direction, and with respect to bullet also it's moving in the same direction. So the relative velocity of bullet with respect to thief is VBT is equal to VB minus of VTJ, where TJ means the velocity of thief with respect to the Jeep. So we are taking this value. That is 150 minus 45, that gives 105 meter per second. Let's move to question number five. A jet plane moving with a speed of 500 km per hour ejects its products of combustion at a speed of 1500 km per hour relative to the jet plane. So that means that's relative velocity. What is the speed of the latter with respect to an observer on ground? So we have this jet plane moving with a velocity Vj, which is equal to 500 km per hour. Now, this relative speed of the products of combustion with respect to the plane, that is VPJ, is minus of 1500 km per hour minus, because their products are moving in a direction opposite to the direction of the jet plane. Here is the observer on the ground, and this VPG is the velocity of the products with respect to the ground, or the observer on the ground. Okay, that is the speed of products of combustion with respect to the ground is VPG. Now, the relative speed of products of combustion, that is these products of combustion with respect to the jet plane, that is equal to VPJ is equals to VPG minus of VJ. We put the values. And what we get? We get VPG is equals to minus of 1000 km per hour. Now this minus sign tells that the direction of motion of the products of combustion is opposite to the direction of motion of the jet plane. So the speed is 1000, because speed can't be negative. The negative sign is only for direction. So let us do question number six, the last one, but one of the best questions. So there are two towns, A and B, connected by regular bus service with a bus leaving in either direction every 2 minutes. A man cycling with a speed of 20 kilometer per hour in the direction A to B notices that a bus goes past him every 18 minutes in the direction of his motion and every 6 minutes in the opposite direction. What is the speed period T of the bus service and with what speed do the buses ply? So the towns A and B, the buses. Okay, let us suppose that the speed of the bus is V kilometer per hour and this is the cyclist moving with 20 kilometer per hour speed. Now what is the relative velocity of bus in the direction of cyclist? V minus 20, because in same direction we subtract. And the relative velocity of bus in a direction opposite to cyclist, v plus 20, because in opposite directions we add. Now, every 18 minutes, what is happening? A bus goes past the cyclist in his own direction. So, what is the distance covered by the bus flying in the direction of the cyclist? It is speed into time. The speed is v minus 20. The time is 18 minutes, that is 18 by 60 hours. Now, what happens every 6 minutes? A bus goes past the cyclist in a direction opposite to his motion. So, the distance covered by the bus plying in the direction opposite to the cyclist is V plus 20 into 6 by 60. Also, since one bus leaves every 2 minutes, so what is the distance traveled by the bus? V into T by 60. V is the velocity, T is the time, which was in minutes, we converted into hours. Let us continue the answer further. This is what we have done in the previous slide. You have seen that these were all the things that we got. Now, V minus 20 into 18 by 60 is equals to VT by 60. That is the distance traveled by the bus. And this is the distance traveled by the bus with respect to the cyclist in the direction of cyclist. Also, in a direction opposite, again the distance traveled should be equal to VT by 60. So from 1 and 2, when we solve this, we get V is equals to 40 kilometer per hour. Now let us find the time also. So from 1, when we put the value of V, we get T is equals to 9 minutes. So these were all the questions. At the end, this is the acknowledgement. I'm thankful to Google and Bing for the images that I got. And I hope you have liked the presentation. Do come for the next one. Thank you so much.